Hello everyone, welcome back to Electrical Lectures channel. In today's video, we are going to clear up one of the most common confusions, the difference between servo motor and a stepper motor. Both look similar and both are used for precise motor control, but they work in totally different ways. So stay tuned, by the end of this video, you will know exactly which one is best suited for your application. So first of all, we will briefly see what is servo motor. A servo motor is a closed loop control motor, which means it does not just rotate blindly. Instead, it constantly checks whether it has reached the correct position or not. It uses a feedback mechanism such as an encoder or a potentiometer to continuously monitor its shaft position. Let's understand this with a simple example. Imagine you tell the servo motor to move to 90 degrees. The controller, like an Arduino, sends a signal for 90 degrees rotation. The motor starts rotating and the internal feedback sensor keeps checking its current position. If the sensor detects that the motor has reached exactly 90 degrees, it immediately stops. And if it overshoots or undershoots, the feedback signal tells the controller and the motor corrects itself automatically. That's why we call it a closed loop system. A stepper motor is an electric motor that converts the electric pulses into precise mechanical rotation through a series of discrete or fixed steps, for example, 2.5 degrees per step. In simple words, instead of rotating smoothly like a normal motor, a stepper motor moves one step at a time. If the motor is designed to rotate 1.8 degree per step, so it means that 200 pulses are required to make one complete revolution of this motor. Now let's see the key differences between these two motors. The first difference is the control type, and this is the biggest difference between these two motors. A servo motor is a closed loop device. It means that motor continuously checks its position using a feedback signal from the encoder or the potentiometer. On the other hand, a stepper motor is an open loop device. It just moves in steps whenever we send pulses without checking if it actually reached the position or not. The next difference is based on the feedback. The servo motor, as I have told you, is a feedback motor that uses the sensor like encoder or potentiometer to know its position. Whereas the stepper motor does not have any sensor and does not have any feedback mechanism. The third difference is based on the rotation. A servo motor moves smoothly from one position to the another. It can rotate continuously or at a fixed angle depending on its type. It can also achieve any angle or position due to its feedback. Whereas a stepper motor moves in small steps, for example, 1.8 degrees per pulse, that way you can actually see the stepping motion when it turns. When it comes to torque and speed, here is the big difference. The servo motor performs better at higher speed. They can deliver strong torque even when rotating fast, and also they can produce the high torque at low speed as well. Whereas the stepper motors have high torque at low speed, but as the speed increases, the torque drops quickly. A servo motor with its feedback system automatically adjusts and corrects its position, so it's more accurate under varying load. On the other hand, a stepper motor gives very precise angular control because it moves step by step. However, it can lose steps if there is an extra load on the motor. Another difference is based on the speed. The speed of the servo motor is high. It can achieve thousands of RPM. Whereas the stepper motor has low to moderate speed, it can also miss steps at high speed. Based on the cost, the servo motor is expensive and also its setup is slightly complex because of its feedback. Whereas the stepper motor is cheaper and its setup is comparatively simpler. Based on the applications, the servo motors are common in robots, CNC machines, drones, and camera gimbals, anywhere precise positioning is needed. Whereas The stepper motors are used in 3D printers, plotters, scanner, and small automation system where the motion is step-based and predictable. So I hope you clearly understand the differences between both these motors. For more interesting videos, stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching.